death toll continues to rise after a massive earthquake hit Ecuador over the weekend. An American is among the victims. The State Department says the unidentified person is among the 415 dead from Saturday's 7.8 quake. Survivors are still being pulled from flattened buildings and mountains of rubble. 2,500 people are injured and scores are still missing. The U.S. military is now sending aid to Japan. A series of strong earthquakes there rocked the southern region of that country. 42 people died. More than a dozen were injured in that quake.
We're going to have earthquakes, major earthquakes in California in our future. There's no question about it.
A cautious prediction today from a local earthquake expert. The recent earthquakes in Ecuador and Japan were both bigger than 7.0 quakes, but it's been fairly quiet on this continent. That had us asking today, is California overdue for a major quake? CBS 13's Kelly Ryan got answers earlier today.
And these red dots are the earthquakes bigger than magnitude 6 that have occurred since 1933.
Professor John Rundle is a distinguished professor in the departments of physics and geology at UC Davis.
Our specialty here is the quantitative study of earthquakes. We simulate them in the computer and we look at the physics behind earthquakes as well.
He's also an earthquake forecaster, and his data shows that things have been pretty quiet in California.
In the 80s and 90s, we had, you know, large earthquakes pretty regularly in California. We haven't had anything like that in 16 years, and that's a little unusual.
Unusual because Rundle's data shows an earthquake cycle with about one large earthquake a year.
There have been 81 earthquakes of magnitude 6 or greater in the California-Nevada region since 1933. That's been 83 years.
The last one, the 6.0 Napa quake in August 2014, more than a year with nothing.
We're due for magnitude 6 earthquakes in a very large region of California, Nevada.
By very large region, he means San Francisco or Los Angeles, but that's not the only threat.
There's a pretty high likelihood of something happening in the next year or two in magnitude 5 or larger. Okay, this is the Loma Prieta earthquake there.
His data shows that with this so-called quake dry spell, even the lack of magnitude 5s means there may be a dangerous buildup under the surface.
We do know from the statistical relations of earthquakes that for every magnitude 6, there's roughly 8 to 10 magnitude 5s. So if you're not having 5s, it means the Earth is storing up energy that could be released in a major earthquake.
And major earthquake, here's one right over my shoulder. This is from 1906. Right now, today, marks the 110th anniversary of the 1906 San Francisco earthquake, where more than 3,000 people died. Hundreds of thousands of people were injured and lost their homes. The quake destroyed much of the city. It caused billions of dollars in damage. So today, it had us wondering, and we asked the question, how much would it cost to prevent significant damage from a future earthquake in Northern California? Well, there is a new LA Times article, and it suggests that a major earthquake could cost upwards of about $3 billion alone for San Francisco's Embarcadero. New studies found that a massive seawall could be shoved towards the bay by more than several feet in a massive earthquake, and taking with it some of San Francisco's most famous and expensive real estate, of course. Experts, by the way, have no estimated cost for Sacramento because the forecast for the next big quake in California are for either San Francisco or Los Angeles.